In software engineering, we are discussing about SDLC. SDLC stands for Software Development Lifecycle. Before discussing software development lifecycle, we are discussing about what is meant by software and what is meant by software engineering. Software is a collection of instructions or set of instructions which are used to operate the computers and computer related things. Software engineering is the process of developing new software with existing software. That means we can implement any software product. Software engineering is the field of engineering to implement new product with standard procedures and tools. SDLC, Software Development Lifecycle. Software Development Lifecycle model is a key concept of software engineering. We can implement any type of software product on field of software engineering. SDLC is the key concept. It is generally consisting of series of stages. SDLC life cycle consisting of sequence of pages, that means collection of pages like requirements, analysis, design, implementation, testing, maintenance. Software life cycle is a generic activity that applicable to all software projects. Software life cycle is a generic activity. Generic activity means general activity, general process for all software projects. For all software projects, SDLC is a general process. It is a descriptive and diagrammatic representation of software product. SDLC represents both descriptive manner and diagrammatic manner. Diagrammatic manner means picture representation. It represents both the ways. That means it is used to how to implement the software and how to execute the software. So both are represented in SDLC. Software development life cycle consisting of series of pages. So software development life cycle is also called as a software development process model. We can process the software product by using of SDLC. This consisting of requirements, analysis, design, development, testing, and maintenance. Requirement is the first page of SDLC life cycle. Requirements are gathered in this page. That means we can identify the requirements for implementing software. This page is the main focus of project managers and stakeholders. Stakeholders means who are involved in implementation and usage of the software, like developers, maintainers, testers, analyzers, customers, and consumers. We can identify the software requirements conducting meeting with managers, stakeholders, and users, or determine the requirements. All are determine the requirements. These are discussing about how will they use the system, what data should be inputted to the system, what data should be outputted by the system. So when we are constructing new house, we are gathering some requirements like sand, iron, bricks, wood, etc. So all these are implementing for or constructing new buildings. When we are implementing new software, we are gathering the requirements, software requirements, hardware requirements, functional requirements, and non-functional requirements. So after identifying the requirements, validate the requirements. Validate means verification of the requirements. Verification means if the requirements, what we are gathering the requirements, what we are identifying the requirements, that requirements satisfies user need or not, that requirements are solve user problem or not. So after identifying requirements, it is validated. So if the requirements are validated without any problem, finally software requirement specification document is created, that is SRS. SRS means software requirement specification document. So SRS is the agreement between the user and manager. SRS document is the agreement between the user and manager. So in this agreement, mention all the requirements to satisfy user needs. In this space, also analyze cost, time, and resources of the project. Which time to take in to implement the project? Which cost? How much cost to implement the project? The next stage of SDLC is design phase. During the design phase, developer and technical designers are involved. So in this design phase, mainly developers and technical designers are involved. Design is the process of representing diagrammatical way of executing software or implementing software. Design is the process of diagrammatical representation of implementing software. Technical details and relation between technical objects are represented diagrammatically in this space. In this space, draw architecture design, system design, interface design, component design, etc. After completion of design phase, validated by the developers, if it is validate, the design phase is usually kept in the design specification document. So after completion of design activity, all the design related things are kept in the design specification document, DSD. So after completion of design, then go to development phase. Development phase is also called as a implementation phase. After the requirements and design activities is completed, start development. In this phase, all the design activities are converted to coding or implementing. This phase is validated by testing. In implementation phase, we are conducting unit testing. Unit testing means to verify each and every modules independently. That means to test each and every modules independently. So next, after completion of unit testing, then go to testing phase. Generally, testing is the last phase of SDLC in a development. Generally, testing is the last phase of development side. Testing is the process of verification and validation of coding. It is verify and validate the code. Verify means all the user requirements are implemented or not. Validation means what we are implementing user requirements, all are correct or not. That is called as validation. There are different types of testing methods, manual testing and automation testing. Automation testing tools are like Selenium, gray box testing, manual testing, black box testing, white box testing, unit testing, integration testing, etc. After testing phase, then start with maintenance phase. One of the software has been fully tested and next thing is maintenance. It is the process of to deploy the product on client or user system. So maintenance is the process of deploy whatever developer developing the product, that product is deployed and installed in the client system.